Let's take a look at some highlights of the new features in this release. We've added more options to command line search. New features include autocorrect and synonym search. You can add your own autocorrect and synonym entries on the Manage tab. To customize the search features, right-click the command line and choose Input Search Options. You'll see that you can also search for different types of content by name. For example, you can type in the name of a hatch pattern and apply it directly from the command line. With Autodesk 360, you can share and access your documents online. Design Feed lets you add messages or images to your drawings and share them with colleagues or clients you tag. Let's say I want to let a colleague know that I'd like to make a change to this door. I type my message, pin it to my drawing, and tag my colleague. He'll receive an email notification. We've improved support for working with geographic data. You must be signed into Autodesk 360 to add live map data to your drawings. To add location information, you start on the Insert tab. I'll enter the address of the location I'm working with, drop the marker, and place it in a position that I can easily map to my drawing, in this case, the corner of the lot. Then I select that location in my drawing, indicate north, and now I see the map behind my drawing. From here, I can add more position markers, control the display of the map, and edit or remove the location data. You can now insert two new point cloud formats generated by Autodesk Recap. The RCS format is a single point cloud file. The RCP format is a project file that references several RCS files. Let's insert an RCP file that consists of several scans created in a boatyard. We've updated the point cloud contextual ribbon to give you better access to the tools for modifying clipping boundaries and applying color stylizations. For example, you can now use the rectangular clipping button to quickly create a new clipping boundary. You can also set color stylizations to help you analyze the point cloud data. For example, you can set the colors to show the surface normals of the scanned objects. If you set the color stylization to intensity, you can change additional color settings. This release installs some Autodesk Exchange apps for you by default. You'll see the Featured Apps ribbon tab with available apps. And on the Plugins tab, you'll find the app for importing SketchUp files, as well as the Exchange App Manager, which lets you manage your installed apps. We've also added a number of drawing enhancements, including the ability to easily create arcs in either direction by pressing the Control key to switch direction as you draw. And you can now use the Fillet and Chamfer commands to close and open polyline. You can merge selected layers by using the shortcut menu in the Layer Manager. You can quickly set XRefs to be attachments or overlays, or change their path type. Explore the online help and other resources to learn more about the new features in this release.